It's Brian Preston, the Money Guy.
Always be learning.
Yeah, I think that it's interesting. We live in a world, in a society today, where the ability for us to expand our knowledge base is maybe easier and better than ever. You can have an answer, not always the right one, but if you do enough research, you can have an answer to almost any question, any problem you have, instantaneously. You know, our ancestors didn't have that. They didn't have the ability to do that. And so right now, folks who aren't taking advantage of that, aren't capitalizing on that, are missing just a wonderful opportunity.
You say our ancestors. I want to give everybody a time capsule. When I was a kid in K through 12, do you know when you had to write research reports? There was no internet back then.
Right.
You were basically, and look, I consider myself blessed that my parents actually bought that expensive encyclopedia set that sat out there, Encyclopedia Britannica or whatever it was that everybody had, and you were time capsuled into the year that your parents bought that. That's where history stopped at that moment. So if your parents bought the 1983 Encyclopedia Britannica and you're writing a research report in 1989, you didn't get the 6 years of innovation in your research, and that's just the way it works now. You can be in any conversation in the world and somebody can say, hey, do you remember? And if you just have like two or three clues, you can type it in on Google or these magical devices that are in your pocket and it will tell you the answer. And I think we take for granted that was not always the case. I mean, information is so much easier, so much freer. But people are not taking that access to the unlimited information out there and turn it into a positive. And that's why I say there's a difference between having access to actually absorbing and then learning and then applying these concepts to create success for yourself. So you need to understand being a student of life can be immensely powerful for you in the long term.
Yeah, Brian, there was I was watching the show, and I can't remember what show it was, but I told you this. There was this great quote on there where the guy said, if you're born poor, you can't control that. Like, that's out of your control. Yeah. But in this country, if you die poor, that one's kind of on you. Because there are opportunities. If you can master some of these commandments, and I think that you and I are prime examples of how education was a ladder out of a circumstance that might have been different. Neither one of us came from money. Neither one of us came from resources. But because we had the opportunity to receive an education, to go out there and learn about financial planning, it created amazing opportunities over the long term. I think that even now today is more available than it was 20, 30, 40 years ago.
No, it is so much better. And by the way, this shows up in the research on society. I mean, that's what I love being a student of life, because you'll come across little nuggets of information. You go, wow, that's something that ought to be shared. And we had a whole discussion in the content meeting about the research, and I can't remember which one of us found it from the content team, but the Brookings Institute has three factors that will actually tell you whether or not you're going to be successful with a probability of, what is it, 97%, 98%? So listen to these markers of success.
So here are three markers of success I came up with. Number one was graduating high school. Number two was working full-time, having a full-time job. And number three was being married before you had children and not having kids before the age of 21. So the Brookings Institution looked at this societal study, and this is what they found. For those that follow all three of these norms, the poverty rate inside that segment of the population was only about 2%.
That's amazing. If those are pretty three things. You know, and that's what they ought to teach that in high school. I mean, these three things, hey, don't do this, do that, and I think you're going to set yourself up. But they also put in the research, what happens if you break all three of these?
Yeah, so for those that break all three norms, the poverty rate grows to 79%. So there are some markers of success, some things that you can focus on that may provide you an opportunity, at least stack the deck in your favor to some extent. Just so you know, overall right now, the poverty rate in the U.S. presently is about 13.7%.
All this is just, I mean, because I know, look, you said it. If you're born poor, we get it. I mean, and that's why we love that we create free content. It's out there. It's accessible. Anybody can watch this. This is your ladder up opportunity.